has taken a hard-line response in the country's escalating political crisis, with vehicles ploughing into protesters who want the president to step down. Nine's US Bureau Chief Robert Penfold has more.
These violent scenes we're seeing coming out of Venezuela have in many ways been expected after it became clear the embattled president there, Nicolas Maduro, was just refusing to stand down despite driving his country into poverty over the last couple of years. And those out on the streets now are supporting the man they believe should be president, Juan Guaido. But the military, well, has been ordered out by the sitting president, the dictator, and we're seeing horrific pictures at the moment of army vehicles being driven into crowds. Then the tear gas started, there were firebombs, and it's also being reported that live rounds were fired as well. Despite having some of the largest oil reserves in the world, the economy there has crashed. People are starving. It's a humanitarian crisis, and it's resulted in a mass exodus of people leaving the country, and that's also created big problems for adjoining countries. The US and Australia, more than 50 other countries, are supporting Juan Guaido and his attempts to take control. Let's have a listen to Secretary of State Mike Pompeo in Washington today, increasing the pressure on Maduro to get out.
It's been a long time since anyone has seen Maduro. He had an airplane on the tarmac. He was ready to leave this morning, as we understand it, and the Russians indicated he should stay. We think the situation remains incredibly fluid.
But really the big worry is that Russia and Cuba are also involved. Cuba has thousands of soldiers there, and they're supporting the dictator Maduro, whose popularity is barely at 20%. And it's worth remembering, too, that President Trump has made a warning. He said he'd even consider military intervention if need be.